Rahman Rahim, my dear respected brothers and elders. Today we will be talking about Tawaf. What does it mean by Tawaf? For those people that have been a number of times for Hajj and Umrah, they will know that Tawaf means to circle the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 7 times. Circulating the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 7 times is called Tawaf. For those people that have not been for Umrah or Hajj before, I'm sure you know you will have seen on TV that people that are circulating the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this circulating the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going around 7 times is called Tawaf. Now there's 2 things that I'd like to mention over here whilst you perform Tawaf. Number one, your satr should be covered. Satr meaning for a male, including the belly button and including the knees. And for a female, her whole body should be covered apart from the face, hands and feet. So number one, your satr should be covered. Number two, whilst you perform Tawaf, you should be in the state of wudu. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that when a person does Tawaf, Tawaf is similar to Salah. So you cannot read Salah without wuzu in the same way you could not do Tawaf without wuzu. Now a few things over here. Before you actually start your Tawaf, note the places where you can perform wuzu if your wuzu breaks. So note these places beforehand. Number two, if your wuzu does break, then for example if I'm doing round number 5 and halfway through round number 5, if my wuzu breaks, I will go perform wuzu and I will come back and I will start at the beginning of round number 5 and I will finish at round number 5, 6 and then 7 onwards. So you will start at the beginning of that round. And number 3, if the salah time starts, then you will read your salah and you will carry on performing your tawaf from where you left off. Now what you have to remember guys is tawaf is something spiritual, it's a connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last thing that you want to be doing whilst you're performing your tawaf is, you know, on the phone with someone or FaceTiming or Snapchatting or WhatsApping. This is the connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the place, if you remember, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walked, the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een walked. So you need to utilize that time. These 7 rounds that you do, you can either pick a certain dua for yourself, for your family members, for someone that you love. For between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this dua you can recite, you can read for every single round that you do, or you can get a book in which it tells you which duas you need to read. Or you can keep it simple and like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam read the dua Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. O Allah, give me good in this world and give me good in the hereafter and save me from the fire of hell. You can read this dua. So whilst you're in tawaf, don't waste your time. Build your connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for all the things that you want. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your duas.